Hi, I'm George, and we're going to be changing the background music here inside of Minecraft Bedrock. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and subscribe as well. When you subscribe, hit that notification icon for notifications of new videos, and check out my channel for a bunch more Minecraft stuff. Okay, the first thing we need to do to change the background music is to get the list of music locations and music names. Let's switch over and take a look at that. Minecraft uses a bunch of different music pieces for the background depending upon where you are and what you're doing. I have a big list here. You can download this list from my website. There's a link for that in the description. I have a basic folder structure right here. That's Minecraft Sounds Music Game. And then there are some additional folders in here for Creative, End, Nether, Water, and Menu right down there. We'll be working with just the Creative section and do just these six files right here just to keep things kind of simple. Now, if you wanted to change all of the background music, you would have to change all of these sound files. So there's a lot of sound files in here to change. Notice that all of these are .ogg files. We need the .ogg format, and for that we'll be using Audacity. I'll show you how to do that in just a little bit. So the first thing we need to do, once we have the basic list, we know which sound files we want to replace, is to set up a new folder for the sound files. Let me bring up a drive window here. There we go. And in here, I've made a new folder. I just called it Bedrock Background Music. You know, call it anything you want. Put it on your hard drive someplace. Doesn't really matter where it is. I have one here for custom resource packs for my Bedrock game. Go inside here, and we're going to be building the whole resource pack inside of this folder. Now, the next thing we need is to get a vanilla resource pack from Minecraft. We need to download that, so I'll bring up a window for that. There we go. And this is at Minecraft.net add-ons. I'll put this link also in the description so you can go ahead and find that. Now when you're here on this one page, scroll down, go past all of this stuff in here, all these pictures, and you want to come down to this paragraph right here, and you want that link right there. It says resource packs. Click on that. This will open up a download window, and we're going to download this down to the folder that we just set up. So go back here. There's the Bedrock Music folder. There it is. I want to download this file into this location. Choose save and let that go ahead and download. It goes pretty fast. It's a small file. And there it is. Okay, let's just get this out of the way temporarily. And here is the vanilla resource pack. Now I need to unzip this. You can use any program you want to unzip this. It doesn't matter. I happen to like using 7-zip. Okay, right click and I'll just do extract all or 7-zip extract here, either one. Just fine. This is going to extract everything inside of that zip file. We're then going to get rid of the stuff that we don't need. And those are going to be mostly things that we don't need. We'll just delete all those excess files. Okay, there we go. It has been unzipped. You can now get rid of this file down here. I'm just going to hit the delete key and delete that. We no longer need that. I always start with a brand new clean one from the web, so I never have to actually save those zip files. Now, in here, there are a few things you need to keep. You need to keep that sounds JSON, you need to keep that pack icon. We'll be replacing this, but I'll keep it here anyway. You need that manifest JSON. Now, if you're just changing the music file, the background music files, and nothing else, we can get rid of a lot of stuff in here. That file right there, I'll hold the control key down and click on all the rest of these things. Keep the sounds folder, and then get rid of everything else. Let's just choose all of that. Hit the delete key, and all that goes away. Now once that's done, we're going to clean up the sound folder. There's a lot of things in here that we don't need also. Let's go ahead and go inside the sounds folder. Now everything in here can go away except for these two bottom files. Make sure you leave those two files. So all these folders go away. So click on the first one here and then scroll down. Click on the last one. Hold the shift key down there. Hit the delete key and all of those go away. All right, that's now done. Now we can come in here and put in some new folders. Click on New Folder, and the folders we'll be putting in is going to be this line right there from the sound list. Okay, so we're in here. Click on New Folder. The first one you want is going to be Music. We're already inside of the Sounds folder. This will be our Minecraft. That's the Sounds. We're here already. So we need to have the Music. Go inside of Music, and in here, a new folder for Game, and then inside of Game, a new folder for Creative. There we go. Now, if you're changing the background sounds for the regular part of the game, that's all this stuff up in here. All of that would go into this spot right there. If we're changing these sounds go inside of the creative folder. They'll go inside here. Okay, So our folder structure is now set and ready to go. We can now begin working on the basic resource pack. Let's back up to our basic folder right there. And in here, we need to edit the manifest.json files. Click on this one. Now I have mine opening up in Notepad. If you don't have that set up, just right-click on this, choose Open With, and then select the Notepad program from the list of files that pop up here. Now, if you're not seeing it in here, just click on More Apps, and you'll find it in that list. Okay, let's go ahead and just say OK. And then mine opens up in Notepad. This is just real easy to do. Now, in here, there are a few things we need to change. We need to change the description right up here. Let's just call this one Background Music. There it is. And you can give it a name right down here. I'm going to call this one Background Music Pack. There we go. And the description down here can be the same as this description right here. So I'm just going to right-click, copy, and just come down here, and then right-click and paste. Okay, so those have been changed. Now, the next thing we have to change in here are these UUID codes. And that's this stuff right in here. There are two of those. There's one there, and there's one here. Now, these codes are kind of like a license plate on a car. It has to be different for every single car. In this case, these UUID numbers have to be different for every single resource pack so that Minecraft can tell them apart one pack from the other. Now, this is a special code, so you can't just make this number up. You have to actually get this number, and let me show you how you do that. I have another website for that, and that's right here, Online UUID Generator Tool. And again, the link for this is in the description. When you get to this page, click on version 4 UUID, that's the one you want. And then just to be on the safe side, come down and click on refresh, which is right there. Make sure you get a nice brand new number. Now click on copy, go back to the manifest.json file, and then select this inside of the quotes, right click and paste. Do it a second time, go back here, refresh the page, these have to be different codes, choose copy, and then back again to the manifest file. Select the bottom code inside the quotes and then paste. And then file, save. Okay, that's done. Manifest is now done. Let's get this out of the way. The next thing we have is this pack.iconpng or pack_iconpng. This is simply the image file that shows up inside of the list just to give you an icon for your resource pack. It can be anything that you want. It's a 256 by 256 file. Now I happen to have my own. Now I have one back here. Let's just find a different one here. There's mine right there. Now I'm just going to right click on this and copy. There we go. And I'll go back into our new resource pack right here. Delete that one and then right click and paste. So now I have my own custom file for that. So the manifest has been done. The pack_icon has been done. We have our folder structure all set up inside of here. Now we need to have our music file. Now I have a sound file already picked out, and if you go back here to Custom Resource Pack, I have it sitting right down in here. There it is, called George Street Shuffle. Different George, but it seemed to work. I'm just going to copy this one, right-click and copy, and I'll go back into our working location and go right into the final directory for our sounds. So sounds, music, game, creative, and then right-click and paste. I'll just put that file right here. Now this is an MP3 file, and I downloaded this from the YouTube music library. So we need to convert this now and get it ready to use inside of the game and then rename that. Now for that, I'll be using the Audacity program. Let me show you where you can find that. And you'll find that right here, audacityteam.org. And again, I'll put this link inside of the description so you have that available. It's a free download, and it's everything you need for working on sound files inside of Minecraft. I'll just scroll down here just a little bit, and there's the download for that right there. Okay, I already have mine installed, so I don't need to have that. Let me bring up that program, and there it is. There's our sound file inside of Audacity. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to convert this from stereo down to mono. There's no reason for stereo inside of the game because we don't have a source that we're looking at. So let's go ahead and change this down to mono. Select the file and then come up here to tracks and mix stereo down to mono. There we are. Now, again, you can use any sound editing program you like. I just happen to like this because it's free. There we are. We now need to convert this over to the .ogg or .ogg format. And that's up here under file. Come down to export and export as .ogg. Now, it's very important that you export this out or save to the OGG format. You can't just rename the MP3 file. That's not going to work. It has to actually be exported or converted to the .ogg format. I'll be keeping it in the same location. Let's go ahead and we'll find that one. And that's right here. There's our Bedrock Music, Sounds, Music, Game, Creative. Same folder right there. Choose Save and OK. This will now save that into that same location, so we'll then have this as an OGG file. Now once this is done, and there it is, that's all taken care of, I can now close this down. I won't bother saving that. And there we are. We now have two copies of this file. One is our original MP3, you can leave that here. One is our new OGG file. What we need are these six files over here, the creative 1 through 6. So I'm going to take this one, I'm just going to rename this one. I'll call it creative 1. There we go. Let's now make copies of this. Copy and paste. And I'll rename this one number 2 here. There we go. And then do this 4 more times so that we now have 6 copies of this file. And there we go. Okay, so we've taken this, we converted this to the OGG format, and then we've copied and renamed that to match the names of the files needed over here in the original list. So there we go. We now have our files all set up. Now all we need to do is to get this over inside of Minecraft. Okay, it's back up here to our basic folder right there. There's our sounds folder, the manifest.json. There's our brand new pack icon, and there's the original sounds. Select all this stuff and then zip this up. I'm going to right click in here. I'll be using 7-zip. Use anything you want to zip it, that's fine. And I'm just going to choose to send this to an archive. We'll do add to archive. Now the most important thing, no matter which program you're using to make a zip, is to make sure that your archive format is set to the zip format. Most programs have several options in here. Make sure it's going to zip. That's very important. And then choose OK. Once that's done, it'll go fast. There's that file. Now the last thing we need to do here is to rename this file. Just change that zip extension over to mcpack. Make sure you see the zip extension. If you're not seeing the extension, click on View up here. And make sure that file name extensions right there is checked. Okay, I'll go back here to home, and let's just change that extension. And it's mcpack. You get the warning in here, just choose OK, and you should see the icon change over to the Minecraft icon. Now, make sure that Minecraft is closed before you do this next step. As soon as you know that Minecraft is not running, just double click on this file, and then Minecraft is going to launch, and as soon as it launches, it's going to install that new pack. Okay, there's a menu screen, and it's starting the import up there. This will import very quickly, and as soon as it's imported, it's going to tell us that it has been imported correctly. There it is, successfully imported, and we're all set to go. Now we need to activate this pack two places. First, from this page, click on Setting, and in here, scroll down to Global Resources right there, go into My Packs, and in here, you should see your new pack at the top of this list. Click on that and click Activate. That moves it from here up into Active. Let's just double check, make sure it's showing in Active. There we go, it's showing in Active. That's fine. Okay, let's back up one step. Let that load in that new resource pack as Active. Now click on Play. This will bring up your list of worlds. Choose a world you want to play in, and then click on the pencil icon over here on the right-hand side. This brings up the settings for that one particular game. And in here, we need to do the same exact thing. Click on Resource Packs, go into My Packs, and in here, there's your background music. Click on that, choose Activate. Now check Active. Let's just open this up. Make sure it's showing up here. There we go. Let's go ahead back out of here. We can now go ahead and play the game. Click on the world, and it's going to load this game in. Okay, we're in the game. I'll just hit the Escape key right now. There we are, and bring up our settings, go into settings, and in here I'll just make sure that the music is clear to the top on that volume. And let's go ahead and find that left-hand side. There's audio, and I'll put that clear to the top. Okay, and then back out again, and resume game. Now it's a little hard to hear again because Minecraft tends to play background music fairly low, so I'm going to boost the volume here in editing so you can actually hear the background. And there you go. That's how to change your background music inside of Minecraft. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and subscribe as well. And check out my channel for a bunch more Minecraft stuff. All right, I'll see you next time.